Hi, I'm Sean from Peak Hi-Fi, and today I'm going to be sharing with you the unboxing of the all-new Thorens TD124DD. After. So, inside the box, here we have the strobe disc, a very substantial platter, lovely heavyweight, with strobe markings on the underside. Machined by from solid aluminium, and it's quite weighty. Like counterweights for the tone arm. A head shell. The user guide. Oh, and this is very nice. This is the serial number, the Thorens certificate, telling us a little bit about the TD124, which was originally introduced in 1957, and I believe it was manufactured through till 1968. Okay, not sure what this is just yet. We'll find out. The next stage is to locate the turntable where it's going to be sighted. So we're going to move it over here, and there are a pair of nice gloves here to stop you getting grease on the platter, so we'll pop those on. When it comes to fitting the platter, there's a rebate at the back here and a small rebate at the front here. It's best if you can lower the platter using your fingers in these rebates so you've got some clearance. Carefully remove this platter, and then line it up. So, as we're doing this, just carefully look through the hole in the platter and align it with a spindle, and drop it gently over, fingers in the rebates. There we go, that drops down on there very nice and gently. There's a bubble level on the Thorens, and we can see that it's not quite level. But to level the deck, there are four adjusters, these small knurled wheels. So we have one wheel that is up by the cueing device here on the front. We have another one to the left of the deck, just here by the speed selector. And then at the rear of the deck, there is one at the rear left and another one at the rear right. Okay, so they're very easy to use. Now we've adjusted that and got that perfectly level. The next stage is installing the anti-skating weight. Just going to slacken this off a couple of turns. So on this next stage, we're going to take the anti-skating assembly and take this eyelet that's on the end of the nylon cord and put it onto the fifth groove on the boom there, the anti-skating boom. So now I'm going to insert the brass weight carefully into this hole and lower it down gently. And then I'm popping in after that the aluminium bearing holder. Right, and if we backed off the grip screw enough, and there we go, that pops in nicely. And the final operation, we're just going to gently tighten this grub screw back up a little bit just to nip in and hold that all firmly in place. The next stage would be to install your cartridge into the head shell if you choose to use the supplied Thorens head shell. I'm going to be using an Autophon SPU cartridge on this. So here we have an Autophon SPU number one E. So we just pop that in here, nip up the bayonet. There we go, cartridge fitted. Next stage is to put the counterweight on, the tone arm weight. The TD124DD comes with two sizes, a smaller counterweight and a larger one. The smaller one would generally work with most cartridges in the supplied head shell, but for heavier cartridges like the SPU, we'll be using the larger counterweight. Ensure the tone arm is locked in place. Here we have this one still locked in as it came out of the packaging. I've now got the larger of the two counterweights, and as you can see, there's a hole in the counterweight for a grub screw. Now we're going to slacken that off slightly before putting that on the rear of the tone arm. The supplied Allen key is perfect for this. So we have that slackened off now. Carefully slide the counterweight onto the rear of the tone arm and very gently close up the grub screw. And the idea is the grub screw will find its location in the spiral grooves. There we go. Don't over tighten this, and as you can see, once it's in successfully, by rotating it forwards, backwards, clockwise, anti-clockwise, it moves backwards and forwards. At this next stage, we're going to set the tracking weight on the tone arm. Couple of things just to look out for. Make sure the cueing device isn't in this position, it's in this position, which is the lower position. And also make sure that the tracking force dial is set to zero here. What we do is we rotate this weight backwards or forwards until we can get the tone arm so that it's in. You need to be very careful at this stage. You don't want the stylus catching on the platter mat. So we're going to just take it slightly over the clamp and see how it's doing. I've adjusted it a little bit. There we go. Yeah, it's neither lifting it up or dropping down at the nose. It's in perfect balance, is that. So now we have the arm perfectly balanced. I'll just pop that back in the lock. And the tracking force is effectively zero at that point. Now we can adjust the tracking force using this scale. And for this cartridge, the tracking force is 4 grams. There we go. The scales aren't always 100% accurate, so we're just going to use a digital scale and just calibrate this. Before we do so, okay, so there we've got a calibrated digital scale, and we're going to just check the tracking force. Set at 4 grams here. It's actually reading 4.9, so I would recommend using a scale, a digital scale. So I'm going to readjust that now so that it measures 4 grams on the scale. So I've backed off the adjustment a small amount, and here we have near as makes no difference. I'm happy with that for a 4 gram tracking force. So the next stage is putting the record onto the platter. Okay, so now the record's in place, I'm just going to check the VTA. So I'm carefully lowering the stylus onto the record. There's plenty of ways to do this, but I'm looking to see if the arm tube is parallel with the record. Now, to me, the arm tube, and I'm not sure if it's going to come over on this this video very well, but the arm tube is definitely slightly higher at the back. On the arm, there's an adjustable collar here. This is a lock ring which needs slackening off. So we're going to just drop the arm slightly using this. To adjust the collar, we need the little tool that's provided. It was the part I didn't know what it was earlier, but here we are, this is it. And we pop the tool into one of these holes here and just slacken off. Rotate slightly, that's the lock nut. Okay, now with the lock nut, I'm going to adjust this collar, which will allow me to move the arm down or up if I wanted to move it up, but down in this case. Okay, I've now rotated that and I'm happy that the arm tube is parallel with the surface of the record. Important that you lock this back up. If you don't, the arm pillar isn't clamped up properly and it won't be nice and tight as it needs to be. The next thing to check is the azimuth alignment. Now, there are a number of ways to do this. There's software, you can do it by computer, you can use a mirror. I like to use a very small bubble level to check that the head shell isn't inclined left to right. And here we go. I've got my bubble level there, and I'm happy that the azimuth on this is in the correct position. Getting the azimuth correct is about having the stylus precisely at 90 degrees to the record groove. Now, when you check yours, if you find that the azimuth isn't correct, you can adjust this. And what you need to do is remove this screw, and this allows you to remove this cover. And under the cover, you can use the small Allen key that has been provided to slacken off the grub screw and then rotate this tube slightly until you get the correct azimuth, tighten it back up and pop the cover back on. So we've reached the point where we're ready to do the electrical connections, but before we do that, I'm just going to remove the protective film from the plinth here. Okay, protective film removed. Now to the next stage. We're ready to connect the power supply. The first thing you need to check is that the voltage is selected correctly for your country. So here we are, 220 to 230 volts, which is correct for the UK. That came with the TD124DD. This is for connecting the power supply to the rear of the turntable. And the mains lead. Unfortunately, the mains lead that's come is a continental adapter, so I'll have to find a UK IEC lead for this. So first we're going to connect the connection cable to the back of the power supply unit and then to the corresponding plug on the back of the TD124. The power supply is now connected to the turntable. I'm going to put a mains IEC lead into the back of the power supply. You don't have to use a fancy one like this. Obviously, the one that comes, if it's got the correct plug on it, you can use that, or a standard IEC lead. I'm using the Siltec Explorer power lead, which I find work very, very well. Power supply all connected. I've popped it down here away from the turntable itself. Sometimes you have to move these things around just to make sure that there's no noise transferred from the power supplies to either sensitive electronic equipment or to turntables. So a little bit of trial and error may be required there. I'm going to use the RCA connectors on the back of the Thorens to connect it to a phono stage. There are XLR connectors if you have the option to connect to a balanced phono stage. Again, I'm using Siltec cables now for connecting. So these are Siltec Anniversary 330. So we'll get those connected and we're just about ready to go. Next thing you want to do, or you may want to do, is connect the turntable ground to the ground on the phono. So here we have a little screw where we can fasten a wire from here to the rear of the phono stage. This stops hum and things like that. The cable used for grounding purposes doesn't have to be anything special at all. I'm using 0.22 millimeter cross-sectional area, oxygen-free copper cable. This is more than adequate. All set to go. Right. Here is the on-off button. It's in the off position at the moment. The LP we have on is a 45 RPM LP, so I'm going to change that to 45. The platter starts to revolve, and here we see the strobe markings. As you can see, the strobe appears stationary on the 45 PM, meaning the speed is correct. However, this can be used here to slow the turntable platter down or speed it up. So then we have an electronic cueing device on this turntable, so we can elevate the cueing platform, pop the tone arm above where we want to drop the stylus, and then lower using the electric cueing device. And there we are, dropping it down nice and gently onto the record. There we are, the Thorens TD124DD.